माय सेल्फ इज योगिता पाटिल. नेम ऑफ द पेपर इज हाइड्रोजियोलॉजी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न वॉटर साइकिल एंड डिफरेंट इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्मिनोलॉजीज इन हाइड्रोजियोलॉजी. वॉट इज हाइड्रोजियोलॉजी? इट इज अ ब्रांच ऑफ जियोलॉजी दैट डील्स विथ स्टडी ऑफ ऑक्रेंस डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड सर्क्युलेशन ऑफ ग्राउंड वॉटर बीनिथ द अर्थ सर्फेस. इट डील्स विथ ऑक्रंस मीन्स वेयर डज द ग्राउंड वॉटर ऑकर बिलो द अर्थ सर्फेस. वॉट आर द इम्पॉर्टेंट रॉक प्रॉपर्टीज फॉर बीइंग गुड एक्वीफर? देन द वर्टिकल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ग्राउंड वॉटर एंड इट्स सर्क्युलेशन. ऑल दीज एस्पेक्ट्स आर स्टडीड इन हाइड्रोजियोलॉजी. हाइड्रोलॉजिकल साइकिल इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन हाइड्रोजियोलॉजी. इट इज अ साइक्लिक जर्नी ऑफ द वॉटर थ्रू एटमोस्फियर लिथोस्फियर एंड हाइड्रोस्फियर. इट इज द सम टोटल ऑफ ऑल प्रोसेसेस इन विच वॉटर मूव्स फ्रॉम द लैंड एंड ओशन टू द एटमोस्फियर एंड बैक इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेशन. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज वॉटर साइकिल. वी आर ऑलरेडी अवेयर अबाउट दिस हाइड्रोलॉजिकल साइकिल और वॉटर साइकिल. ड्यू टू सोलर रेडिएशन वॉटर इवेपोरेट्स फ्रॉम द वॉटर बॉडीज लाइक सी और लेक्स एंड ऑल्सो फ्रॉम प्लांट लीव्स थ्रू द प्रोसेस लाइक ट्रांसपिरेशन. देन दिस स्टीम राइजेस इन द एटमोस्फियर. देयर इट गेट्स कूल्ड कंडेंस्ड एंड अगेन रिटर्न टू द लैंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रेसिपिटेशन. दिस प्रेसिपिटेशन इज वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट एज इट शेप्स द अर्थ सर्फेस एंड इट इज वेरी यूजफुल इन डिफरेंट जियोलॉजिकल प्रोसेसेस एस्पेशली वेदरिंग एंड इरोजन. एंड दिस प्रेसिपिटेशन इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर मेकिंग वॉटर बॉडीज लाइक लेक्स एंड रिवर्स. सम पार्ट ऑफ दिस प्रेसिपिटेशन गेट्स इनफिल्ट्रेटेड इन टू द ग्राउंड and this forms a groundwater. And finally, this part of the surface and underground water leads to the sea. During this journey, water is converted in all phases, gas, liquid and solid. And over millions of years, this cycle has been taken place on the earth. And it is very, very essential for existence of our earth. This is the cyclic journey of water through atmosphere, lithosphere and hydrosphere. And it is called as hydrological cycle. Here it is seen in the diagram. The transpiration has been taken place, that is the form of evaporation from plant leaves. Then groundwater is seen here. Surface water gets evaporated. It forms steam, it gets condensed and cooled and again comes back in the form of precipitation. Again, this precipitation makes up water bodies and also part of groundwater. And this cyclic journey continues. This is another diagrammatic representation of water cycle. Then important terms in hydrogeology. We are kept saying about precipitation, but precipitation is not only in the form of rain. It is in the form of rain as well as freezing rain, sleet, snow or hail. All these are forms of precipitation and it is the one of the most important term in hydrogeology. It is the primary connection in the water cycle that provides for the delivery of atmospheric water to the earth. But mostly the precipitation is in the form of rain. In the hilly terrain or in the glaciated areas, it is in the form of sleet, snow or hail. Then second term is evapotranspiration. Means evaporation plus transpiration. It is a combined loss of water from a given area by evaporation from the land and transpiration from plants. Means when we are studying the evaporational losses from a particular area, we have to take into consideration the loss of water both in the form of evaporation as well as from in the form of transpiration. It is the sum of evaporation from the land surface plus transpiration from plants. Here we can see the loss of water from the land in the form of evaporation and from the plant leaves in the form of transpiration. Atmospheric factors affecting transpiration. There are certain factors which affect the process of transpiration. It is not same all over the earth's surface. The first factor is temperature. It is directly proportional with temperature. If the temperature rises, the rate of transpiration also gets high. When the air is warmer due to stronger sunlight, the temperature is high and it causes the plant cell, which controls the openings or stoma where the water is released to the atmosphere, to open. Whereas when the temperature is low or in colder areas, these stomas are generally closed, which minimizes the losses due to transpiration. Means it is dependent on temperature. If temperature rises, transpiration rises and vice versa. Then second factor is relative humidity. As the relative humidity of the air in the particular area it gets lower, the transpiration rate also gets higher. It means that it is inversely proportional with relative humidity. If humidity rises, the transpiration rate falls and vice versa. It means that in the drier air, the transpirational losses are higher as compared with saturated air. Then wind and air movement. If there is higher rate of wind is there, then transpirational losses are also higher. Then soil moisture availability. When moisture is lacking, plants can begin to senesce and transpire less water. It is very easy to understand that if there is no surplus moisture, the plant has to save the water as much as possible. In that case, the losses due to transpiration are minimum. If moisture is higher, the loss will be higher. If moisture is low, the loss will be low. Then the plant species, the type of plant. Different plants transpire at different rates. Some plants grow in arid regions such as cacti and they conserve water by reducing or minimizing the transpiration as compared with other plants. The next term is infiltration or percolation. It is the process by which water on the ground surface enters the soil. It is governed by two forces, gravity and capillary action. Infiltration rate in soil science is a measure of the rate at which a particular soil is able to absorb rainfall and irrigation. It means that capacity of every soil is different to absorb water and it is measured in inches per hour or millimeters per hour. When the soil becomes moist or gets saturated with water, this infiltration rate decreases. Also, if the precipitation rate is higher than that of the infiltration rate, runoff will occur. The surface water bodies are formed when the rate of precipitation is higher than that of the rate of infiltration or percolation. This is the process of infiltration. If the soil or rock formations are non-porous, it is very less, and if the rock formation or soil are porous, there is higher rate of infiltration is there. So we have studied different terms in hydrogeology. Thank you.